Devices capable of IP communications must be configured with an IP address to enable network layer functionality. This IP address defines its physical location on the network and is associated with the interface via which the device connects to the network. In this presentation, we'll learn the different methods of assigning IP addresses and other network parameters to devices. Hello guys, we'll talk about the IP address assignment methods. Some parameters the devices require for IP communications includes 1. IP address and subnet mask. This serves as a unique identifier for the device interface connected to the network, and is the main parameter defining the location of this interface. 2. Gateway IP address. To understand gateway, it is necessary to note that a layer 3 device, such as a router, is used to connect different local network segments or broadcast domains together. When an end station needs to exit its local broadcast domain to communicate with a device in another broadcast domain, it sends the frame to the specified gateway before this packet is routed by the gateway device to the destination device. 3. DNS server address. We can describe DNS using a mobile phone. It is used for dialing phone numbers and not names. However, humans remember text more easily. Hence, the existence of a phone book saves us the hassle of memorizing every single phone number on this device. This phone book helps to translate a name to a phone number before dialing. In a similar way, servers on the internet are reachable through IP addresses, and it is easier for humans to remember these servers using domain names such as facebook.com or google.com instead of their IP addresses. However, these texts are not recognizable until they are translated into an IP address by a DNS server. A DNS server is like the phone book of the internet. More parameters may also be configured if necessary. This method of assigning network parameters is called manual allocation, and it is suitable for scenarios where only few devices need to be configured, or where devices need a fixed address, such as a gateway router, printer, or server on the network. These parameters, once assigned, remain permanent unless they are modified by the network administrator. Moving on, please take a moment to hit the subscribe button and turn on bell notifications so you'll be the first to know when we release a new video like this one. The second method is automatic allocation. Automatic processes on a network are managed by protocols running over the network. An example of a protocol under this category is a reverse address resolution protocol, or RARP. When a new computer or a diskless computer, that is, a computer with no independent storage, software, or operating system is connected to a network and boots up, it broadcasts an RARP request packet containing its MAC address information in order to obtain its IP address information. This broadcast is received on the interface of an RARP server, which has been pre-configured with MAC address to IP address mappings for devices on the local network. Upon receiving this broadcast, the server searches this table and sends a response packet containing the IP address of the client when a match is found. This client then initializes its TCP/IP protocol stack for IP communications. Another protocol is the Bootstrap Protocol, denoted by BOOTP. It functions in a similar way to RARP. However, the main difference between these protocols is BOOTP functions across multiple network segments with the help of a BOOTP relay agent. While RARP, which does not have a relay agent, only functions at the link layer since broadcasts cannot be forwarded across networks. These protocols, although automatic, still require some manual configurations to be performed, as their protocol packets cannot carry all the information that may be required by the client, and IP addresses assigned are also static. The third method is dynamic allocation. Any protocol under this category is a dynamic host configuration protocol, or DHCP. DHCP is an application layer protocol released by the Internet Engineering Task Force as an extension of BOOTP. A device called a DHCP server is configured to dynamically assign an IP address and other network configuration information to a DHCP-enabled client device. The DHCP protocol is compatible with BOOTP, which means a BOOTP client can obtain IP configurations from a DHCP server. DHCP clients request for IP address configuration from the DHCP server. The server selects an available IP address from a configured address pool and leases this address to the client for a specific time period. When the lease expires, this client must relinquish this IP address configuration. In summary, IP address configuration methods can be classified as manual and automatic, or static and dynamic. The following applies depending on the selected classification. We'll look at DHCP overview in the next presentation. Until then, please subscribe and turn on bell notifications. See you in the next one, and thanks for watching.